Hello everyone again, and today I am back to make a review video of the new Little Mermaid 2013 doll from the Disney store and JCPenny. So I'm going to do a comparison of the Disney store one and the JCPenny one. So let's get started. Okay, so first of all, let's start with the boxes. This is the Disney store one, and this is the JCPenny one. They sell Disney store stuff and JCPenney, but it's more basic and it's more affordable. And the Disney store ones are obviously more expensive and they have more quality and detail to them than the ones in JCPenney. As you can see, the boxes say everything. This is the JCPenney one and this is the Disney store one. This one has more detail than this one. This one was $12 and this one was $16. So of course, you know, it's gonna have more things. This is the side of the boxes. This one is very beautiful. This one's just really basic, nothing really. And then the back of them, JCPenney, Disney Store. This one has beautiful detail on it. I like all the designs that they put of them, like of the jewelry and stuff. This one just has a picture of Ariel and Atlantica and all other dolls you can collect. And then the other side. That's basically it. I got the Disney Store. I got the JCPenney one for $12 and the Disney Store one was $16. So now I'm going to do a review of the dolls themselves and I'm going to do pros and cons of each of the dolls. So let's get started. Okay, so this is the JCPenney one and this is the Disney Store one. As you can tell, I don't know if you can tell right away, but this one has less detail and less things that this one has. Let's get started with the head. Okay, so this is the JCPenney one, this is the Disney Store one. The JCPenney one, her head is not, it's plastic, but it's really hard, like you can't even squish it. This one is the Disney Store one, and you can squish it. And as you can tell, oh snap, my camera's out here. This head, as you can see, this one has a little bit more cheeks than this one, and the eye colors are different. This one has a darker blue, this one has more of a sky blue, tealish eye color, and this one's smile is different from this one. And this one has cut bangs, and they're gelled to the side. This one doesn't. It's just a continuation, her bangs. They're not gelled or anything. This one has long hair, and this one has short hair. But they're the same hair quality, except for this one, it's a little bit more darker than this one. On my computer screen, I don't know what's happening, but it looks more, a little bit different, but this one's hair is darker than this one. The bras, as you can tell, this one is just one shiny, glittery bra. This one, they just, like, glued on a piece of pasta, put glitter on it, and a jewel, and they called it a day. It's not really that great of a bra. I would go with this one. Unless you like this one, then go with this one. Now, with the tails. This one is more movie accurate. The color is more movie accurate than this one. This one is just green. Some green, cheap fabric material with tulle. With one layer of tulle. This one is teal. And it has scales, glittery scales. And this one has two layers of tulle in the tail and on the waist. This one is just one. So this one, as you can tell, this one is more see-through than this one, meaning this one has two layers of tulle, which and this one doesn't. Which obviously, because this is more affordable than this one. And this one, you can has articulation on the wrists and on the elbows and on the arm. I mean, on the shoulder and the head. This one and on the legs right here, only right here. And right here, you can only crack it, you know, it's not like really bendable, like Barbie's arm. And this one, you can't move anything, just the arm up and down, and then the head sideways up and down, and then the legs are the same on both of them. Now, with the pros and cons, I would go, if you like, well, the pros of this one is that it has great articulation, it has more detail, and the tail and the bra are just amazing. All the detail on the face and everything, those are the pros. The cons are that you can't articulate the leg, the knee or the ankle fully. and the bangs are not cut and gelled to the side, because and then that will become a problem, because then it just gets mixed up into the other hair when you're playing with it, and then it just becomes this red, like, it doesn't even look like she has bangs after. Those are the cons of this one, and it's really expensive, you know, and you're just paying for the articulation, the bra, and the tail, basically, because they're almost the same, except for this one has articulation in the arms. The pros of this one is the hair is longer, it's cut to the side, it's gelled, you can fix it however you want, and it's, I like this one better from the head, because it's not squishy plastic, it's actually hard. This one is squishy, and I don't like that. I think this one's better. This one, I think, has a better face sculpt than this one. That's just my opinion. And another pro is that she's pretty. And the cons is that you can't. This one has no articulation at all, like on the arms. The cons, the tail and the bra are really ugly and cheap and just very ugly, very poorly made. I mean, it's sewed everything good, but it's just that, you know, it's really, you know, come on. This tail is obviously better than this tail. And the bra is better on this one than it is on this one. And yeah, that's my review of the two Little Mermaids dolls from Disney Store and JCPenney 2013. So I hope to see you guys later, and comment and subscribe, and I'll be making more videos and giveaways in 2014. Stay tuned. Bye.